will have a game plan. It may be a different kind of fight. I said maybe. We will see.
Bradley is.
No, it's
Bradley can have a lap.
That's not the point. Bradley's not going to do anything but listen to Teddy Atlas. And let me tell you why. He did it against Brandon Rios, and he hired him for a reason. Okay? He was a man who admitted, yes, I've been a world champion. Yes, I'm a good fighter, but I can improve on my boxing. I want a coach that really knows the sport. Some people like to call it the fight game. They don't understand boxing is a sport. Teddy Atlas understands the sport. Timothy Bradley is trying to take some of that wisdom, add it into his style. They've had a short relationship. What is that going to bring that night versus Manny Pacquiao? We all will see, man.
You might have already said this, but how did Danny's performance do compared to your performance over Guerrero?
You know, I think, you know, Danny, I was aggressive from the start, you know. I got in Guerrero's face a little bit more. I tried to make Guerrero back up. I did also move backwards, but some of my moving backwards was due to the hematoma, you know, and not really wanting to move in, not wanting to cause headbutts, not wanting to work on the inside. I created a knockdown. He didn't create a knockdown, you know. So in comparison, man, you know, I mean, I guess I did more damage, you know. I think I might have even took a little bit of less damage. But Danny boxed kind of swift. Danny Swift Garcia, look at that. Oh, I did not mean to do that, you know. But he did box a little swiftly around the ring, constantly moving, and eventually he realized how. Maybe that's what ended up happening. It took a while, but as Guerrero kept pressing, but wasn't the same intense fighter from the first three rounds, it was easier for Danny Garcia to time his punches. Another thing is, I think Danny Garcia was a little too tense with his big right hooks and right hands. I think he was a little too tense early on, and Guerrero's reflexes were sharp early on. So as the reflexes started to subside, and then as Garcia started to relax. You've seen how he put the hand down. You know what I'm saying?
I've never seen Danny do that before.
You know, he started to relax. And in that relaxing, I think he kind of maybe frustrated Guerrero. And Guerrero just wanted to keep pressing. But being relaxed allowed him to finally start timing. Boom, boom. You know, he showed a few shoulder rolls, quick right hands, mimicking Floyd. You know, I was throwing right hands down the middle. I knew that that was a landable punch. It's there for southpaws. It's a bread and butter. But Guerrero does walk into it from time to time. He walked into several of them tonight. So, you know, it took him just a little bit to get his groove, man. But when he got it, he had it, and he stuck to it. It was a good performance.
Do you think he's improved night and day, Danny? Like, you looking at it, potentially you could fight Danny in a unification match if you go ahead and beat Sean. How do you see him? Is he getting better? Did he not look good? I spoke to Amir. Amir told me that, to him, Danny didn't look good.
You know, Danny didn't look special. He didn't look special. But we've argued, and people have argued, and people have talked about, oh, Herrera beat him, Lamont Peterson beat him. And why is that? It's because Danny don't be looking special, man. He doesn't look special, but he does what he needs to do to win the fight. You know, he keeps his hands up. He was ducking a lot. He was ducking down really low and just moving and moving and making it difficult. Guerrero saw the duck. He was trying to throw the uppercut from time to time, but Danny was going beyond that, and his head was over here instead of there. And because he was ducked down, you no longer can, a southpaw, just like how I got caught versus Luis Collazo, that left hook from a southpaw position can come either right to the solar plex or right here. But as soon as a fighter bends down like this, now your only option is to kind of get him in the chin. You no longer have the body shot. I think Guerrero was landing that left to the body early on, but as Garcia kept doing the duck, kept moving, I mean, Guerrero just didn't have the proper angle to do any real damage.
How do you beat Sean? I didn't get a chance to talk to you. How do you beat him?
You know, we beat him however he lets me beat him.
Mm-hmm.
If it's moving forward, moving backwards, on the inside, on the outside, if it's with that one shot, you never know.
Mm-hmm.
So tune in.
Thank you, Keith.
Thank you. All right.